Hi, my name is Jill C. Smith, also known as Jill Charlene. I'm a childcare provider, a former teacher, voice instructor, an author, but most important, I'm a parent. Our topic for today is human trafficking. I remember a long time ago when I was a little girl, maybe 6 or 7, I was lost in the city. And I was lost from my family for maybe a good 30 minutes. I don't know how much time transpired. However, I was one of the lucky ones. My family got me back. And my mother, when she would recall that situation, I remember her telling how devastated she was at the thought of she might never see me again. Other parents are not that lucky. There are children that have gone to school, gone to the playground, gone to a friend's house, and they were lost to their families forever. Their parents never saw them again. Some of them were killed. Some of them went into prostitution. Some of them were even sent out of this country. Most of them that totally vanished from their family, it could safely be said that they were a victim of human trafficking. Human trafficking, if I was to try and give a definition of that, human trafficking is when a person is taken from their home or, you know, wherever they're at that point, and they are forced into either prostitution, they're taken against their will. Some are not taken against their will, but it's sort of like a slavery, which is well known to this country. Years ago, many years ago, slavery was in force. And people think now that slavery doesn't exist. Back then, people were sold into slavery by the tribes. And some people were just stolen. However, it's still prevalent today. Slavery still exists. Human trafficking robs its victims of their dignity and their childhood. It destroys their lives and it kills their dreams. I have a list of websites that I can give to you for time's sake. It has survivor stories as well as statistics that you would deal with. I am going to mention just briefly, just for your information, and this is a report from 2004 through 2006. According to the TIP reports of 2004 all the way through 2006, it was stated that about 600,000 to 800,000 victims are reported to be trafficked across international borders each year. And this is just the reported incidents. There are things that we should look out for to protect our young children. Some of which, as young as 9, 14 is the average age that especially young girls are taken through human trafficking. However, that's not the case of that always. Sometimes it's boys, sometimes it's very young children. Some dangers that can put you at risk, poverty, dangers through social media, isolation and depression, drug use, sexual promiscuity. These are things that can be warning signs. Not everybody that deals with these things end up being a victim of human trafficking, but it's things to look out for. Social media can be a dangerous area for your children, your teens to be venturing into without some guidance and without some rules put in place to keep them safe. Also, we have a lot of things that are happening in Atlanta. It's worldwide, but it's right here at home as well. And this is a situation that increases each year. It's a problem that needs to be dealt with. And hopefully, in the future, we'll find things put in place that can prevent this from happening to more children each year. I want to thank you for your time. And I do have a list of the websites. One book that's good to look into, Human Trafficking Around, Hidden in Plain Sight by Stephanie Hepburn and Rita J. Simon. Thank you.